Deep in the jungle, American soldiers hunt their enemies. The year is 1962, and this footage was filmed at the Northern Training Area in Okinawa. Throughout the Vietnam War, American troops were sent here for counter-guerrilla instruction. During the 1960s, the war in Vietnam became increasingly brutal, a nightmare for both civilians and soldiers. The American military sprayed massive volumes of chemical herbicides, including Agent Orange, the length and breadth of South Vietnam. Even today, more than 3 million Vietnamese are still suffering from the devastating consequences of these chemicals. But some people believe that the toxic effects of these herbicides extended beyond Vietnam to the island of Okinawa. Former American service members claim that they are sick with health problems caused by exposure to Agent Orange while serving in Okinawa.
Oh yeah. My haircut courtesy of the chemo.
Both of these toes were completely up underneath the second toe. Uh-huh. This third one was, you could barely even see the nail. It was completely hidden.
You got to go where they tell you to go and do what they tell you to do. And we did that. Now when it comes time that we have issues, our governments turn their back on us.
I'm worried about how we can take care of the safety for the children who will be born in the future.
We have it in the Yambaru, we have it in Yawase, Naha Port, Kadena, Camp Schwab, Machinato, Futenma, White Beach, Camp Kue. I found evidence of the wide-scale use of Agent Orange on Okinawa, spanning over a decade and covering the length of this island, from the Yambaru in the north down to Naha in the south.
British journalist John Mitchell has been investigating the issue of Agent Orange in Okinawa.
They were tainted with poison. But even though they knew that these...
This article was written by Mitchell in April 2011. After interviewing more than 20 American veterans who were stationed in Okinawa during the 1960s and 1970s, Mitchell established that Agent Orange had been stored and used on U.S. military installations in Okinawa.
So the veterans who have talked to me, when they used and handled Agent Orange on Okinawa, they never had any protection. They did not wear gloves, they did not wear masks, because they were told by the government that these chemicals were safe. So I really believe that time is running out for these veterans. One of them passed away during my research, and three more have been seriously ill. Because of this, I think we need to continue to research this issue as quickly as possible.
In an effort to overcome guerrilla warfare tactics in the jungles of Vietnam, the American military sprayed enormous volumes of defoliants over forests and crops. It was intended to weaken the enemy by stripping away their hideouts and cutting off their food supply. The U.S. military employed several kinds of defoliants during the war, but the extremely toxic Agent Orange, dispersed in huge quantities over rural Vietnam, remains the most haunting. The orange-striped barrels that stored the substance are a lasting symbol of the horrors of that war. In Vietnam, people who were directly exposed to Agent Orange suffer from a range of cancers, diabetes, and severe skin diseases. Also, their children and grandchildren are plagued by birth defects and congenital diseases. The number of people affected in Vietnam exceeds 3 million.
Oh,
Mitchell teaches English university classes and writes articles for newspapers and magazines. Mitchell's interest in Okinawa comes from parallels with the history of his own homeland, Wales. An early colony of England, Wales was once an independent nation with a unique language and culture.
I think the reason that I'm so interested in Okinawa is because I'm from Wales. And I think Wales and Okinawa has so many similarities. The first time I came to Okinawa, I heard about the Hogen Fuda that people had to wear if they spoke the Okinawan language. And we had the same system in Wales. The English, they tried to control our culture and they tried to wipe out the Welsh culture.
He expressed his feelings about Okinawan people's struggle against the construction of a new military base on the island.
So I think it's unfair for Tokyo to ask Okinawa to have the burden of military bases on the island. It's not a political issue, it's a human rights issue, and people in Okinawa are standing up for those very basic human rights.
In April, Mitchell visited the United States to meet American veterans firsthand. U.S. Air Force veteran Joe Sipla welcomed Mitchell at the hotel in North Carolina.
Yeah, who else am I going to be?
Hey, Joe, it's been a long year, mate.
Sipla believes that he is suffering from health problems caused by Agent Orange while serving in Okinawa. In 1970, when Sipla was 19 years old, he worked at the Owasse communication site as a generator specialist. The facility had many antennae for communicating with ships on the Pacific Ocean and aircraft. Sipla and his fellow service members sprayed Agent Orange to kill weeds and repel insects. They never imagined that they were exposing themselves to deadly poisons.
It was mixed 50-50. I was instructed how to do it. I was told that it was Agent Orange. It was a herbicide. It would also help to keep the mosquitoes down. And then there was to spray the 137 acres of antennas. So let's break that down into two pieces. In the compound, I might do that every couple of 3 weeks, that kind of thing, just to make sure nothing was growing. You mow the lawn, you spray it, even though most of it was dead all the time, you'd keep respraying it, keeping in mind that it kept the mosquitoes down too.
Right.
Okay. At a wasp.
After Sipla completed his 10-month service, he went home to the United States.
I think he made it.
However, immediately upon his return, he began suffering from strong headaches and serious skin problems.
But the little girl's part bothers me. That still bothers me.
The following year, Sipla got married. His wife soon became pregnant, but she lost her first baby. Sipla says he will never forget what the doctor told him at the time.
That the baby died, the fetus died. He said the fetus was so malformed that you would not have been happy.
The doctor asked Sipla whether or not he had ever come into contact with Agent Orange.
He didn't say that to me, but he said, were you exposed to Agent Orange? And then said, be happy that the baby didn't see the light of day because it was so malformed. I can only assume today, I can assume that the doctor made the connection.
Sipla's wife was given treatment at a military hospital. Based on remarks made by the doctor in that hospital, Sipla believes that medical professionals in the U.S. military already suspected that Agent Orange could possibly cause harm to the human body. Sipla and his wife had two more children. However, both have congenital diseases. This is Sipla's daughter, Nicole, born with deformed toes on both feet. She has undergone surgery on numerous occasions to remedy the problem.
Both of these toes were completely up underneath the second toe.
Uh-huh.
This third one was, you could barely even see the nail. It was completely hidden. So that was...
Well, we noticed this when she was very young. We started to see that she was having issues with walking. When I took her to the doctors, they were just perplexed. They really had no medical reason that they knew of.
You know, me not to be able to do a lot of the things that other kids got to do, you know, running and playing, and so it was very painful. Well, I just, unfortunately, I knew that was something I had and I had to live with, so, you know, I try to make do with it.
Right, and do you have any treatment?
Backed up on us.
Today, Spala suffers from several Agent Orange-related diseases, including diabetes.
All of these ships manifest young females. And so, what do you know about that?
He started to suspect that his own sicknesses and those of his children were caused by Agent Orange after watching affected Vietnamese children on TV.
As I was doing the research, I could see how the Vietnamese babies were born. And then I started to see several American servicemen's babies and their grandchildren. And I started to see the same deformities and kind of drew that, connected the dots. My DNA that brought her into this world, and so you feel responsible. If my DNA was damaged, then apparently that was the case, although...
Spala is not alone. Other American veterans believe that they and their family members are suffering from health problems caused by their exposure to Agent Orange in Okinawa.
Hi.
How are you?
How are you? Thank you for letting me come in.
In 1975, Kathy Goetz worked at the headquarters of Camp Foster in Okinawa.
Oh, yeah. You know, my haircut courtesy of the chemo. So...
Diagnosed with multiple melanoma,
Goetz
is now receiving chemotherapy treatment. Her children and grandchildren also suffer from severe health problems.
I'm at the VA. Well, my oldest daughter, I was pregnant with her in Okinawa. In fact, she was born in Okinawa. And she has several medical problems. She's diabetic. She also... they discovered that her kneecaps are not formed properly. My youngest grandchild, her son Nathan, he's 3, and he has speech delays. My granddaughter, who's now 15, she has vision problems. Her eyes don't focus correctly. Question is how far down it goes, whether it goes even beyond the generation that's exposed, down to the grandchildren.
The doctor who diagnosed Goetz with multiple melanoma asked her whether she had ever come into contact with Agent Orange. But Goetz has never been to Vietnam. Then she remembered the time in Okinawa that she was pregnant with her daughter. She used to take walks around the base.
I just saw them spraying 2 or 3 times. You know, like a gasoline kind of smell, and you know, at one time the wind was blowing a little bit, blew on me, but you know, I didn't think anything about it.
Sipala and Goetz are convinced that their own health problems and those of their families were caused by Agent Orange. They are currently seeking compensation from the American government. However, the government denies that it has any records of Agent Orange or other herbicides being stored or used in Okinawa. According to the documents released by the American government, the military tested Agent Orange and stored it in Thailand, Laos, and Cambodia, as well as the demilitarized zone between North and South Korea. But despite the fact that Okinawa served as a frontline base throughout the Vietnam War, the American government has never admitted it kept Agent Orange on the island. Hoping to gather proof of the damages caused by Agent Orange in Okinawa, Sipola started a website in 2011. 25 veterans who claim they are victims of Agent Orange have contacted Sipola through the site.
Another guy sending me an email or a message to another one, and it just kept on growing like a spider's web. It just, everybody started to connect. And how they had sprayed, and the stories became identical. Never met these people before. Their sicknesses were similar.
That was TDY.
This is one of the veterans who made contact with Sipola.
They always do that, like.
James Spencer was a United States Navy longshoreman on Okinawa's military docks. Now suffering from severe diabetes, Spencer is confined to a wheelchair.
At Tiangan Pier, we did some spraying, and he said it's a defoliant. He said they use it, the same stuff they use in Vietnam to kill the trees in the jungle so the enemy cannot hide. And I told him, I said, it must be some stout stuff, because just in a matter of days, everything was dead.
Spencer says he often helped to offload consignments of Agent Orange while working at Naha Military Port. He still remembers the names of the ships that carried the defoliants.
To Vietnam. And they came in about every 2 months. We would bring those in. Victory lines. The Sea Lift, the Comet, the Transglobe, Bear Lines.
These are some photographs of Naha Port.
Mitchell showed Spencer some photographs of the port taken in 1972.
This ship right here is the Transglobe.
One of the photographs showed the ship which regularly transported Agent Orange to Okinawa.
It's just the way it's made. None of the rest of them are made like that. And if you could blow it up right here on the back, if they could be blown up, this thing right here would let down. But that's the Transglobe, I'm pretty sure.
Amazing. What a coincidence that they caught that.
The SS Transglobe was often seen at Okinawa's ports. This photograph was taken at Naha Military Port in August 1968. Alongside the Transglobe, there are two American nuclear-powered submarines. During the Vietnam War, the US military sent supplies to its ports in Okinawa on a daily basis. After being transferred to landing ships, those supplies were then being sent to Vietnam. The US military shipped everything through Okinawa, from cigarettes and toilet paper to weapons and ammunition. Yosei Onaga used to work at Naha Military Port. He remembers what it was like at that time.
At the peak of the Vietnam War, there were many people working at the port, including about 2,000 longshoremen. When frozen goods came in, we used to work for 2 days straight in order to unload them. The military also transported the tanks and vehicles that had been destroyed in Vietnam to the port. Those were brought to Camp Kinzer. When I saw how damaged they were, I was shocked by what the war had done.
The headline of the Stars and Stripes newspaper, published in December 1965, shows how the US military saw Okinawa in terms of the Vietnam War. Can't get along without Okinawa. This was a remark made by Admiral U.S. Grant Sharp Jr., commander of U.S. forces in the Pacific. Sharp pointed out that Okinawa played a vital role as a major training area, support base, and staging point for the Vietnam War. In 1967 at the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, Edwin Reischauer, who was the U.S. ambassador to Japan and a professor at Harvard University, talked about the U.S. military bases in Okinawa.
The problem has been that our bases in Okinawa are not encumbered with certain restrictions that apply to our bases in Japan itself. Bases without these restrictions are not only important and valuable to the American military position, but they are also important for defense of Japan itself.
Okinawa is an expedient place for the United States because it could be freely used at any time. However, one particular incident provoked protests from the people of Okinawa. In 1965, B-52 bombers flew to the island's Kadena Air Base to escape a typhoon. Nicknamed Black Killers by Okinawan people, the B-52s stayed at the base and then flew to Vietnam for their bombing missions. Nagahiro Kuniyoshi, a retired reporter for the Okinawa Times, covered controversial issues regarding the military bases in Okinawa.
I got angry with the fact that B-52 aircraft flew to Okinawa with the reason to escape the typhoon, and then they used the island as a base to bomb Vietnam. I think Okinawan people had mixed feelings when they watched the TV news of B-52 bombing Vietnam.
While interviewing a person from northern Vietnam, Kuniyoshi felt strongly that Okinawa was in a delicate situation. The president of Hanoi's Vietnam National University had come to Japan to participate in the 7th World Conference against atomic and hydrogen bombs. He argued that the U.S. military bases in Okinawa were bringing the Vietnamese people suffering.
He said that Vietnamese people were suffering because Okinawa hosted U.S. military bases. He said that there would be more casualties unless Okinawan people did something against it. Although Okinawan people were also the victims of American military bases, I had to acknowledge the fact that we had a part in the bombing of Vietnam too.
Even though Okinawa was the main staging point for the Vietnam War, during which the U.S. military sprayed Agent Orange as a chemical weapon, the American government still does not admit its herbicides were ever present in Okinawa. However, there have been several incidents involving suspected herbicides in Okinawa.
I think there was a small valley around here. The U.S. military casually dumped here pentachlorophenol, since there were piles of waste sugarcane stalks.
For the first time in years, Chokei Yoshida is revisiting the site he once inspected for work. Yoshida used to be responsible for public health sanitation in the Nukin government when Okinawa was under American administration. There is one incident that has stayed with Yoshida for a long time. In 1971, Yoshida received a phone call from a nutritionist at a school lunch center. He said the tap water smelled like gasoline. After his investigation, Yoshida discovered that huge amounts of toxic pentachlorophenol herbicides had been dumped in the Haiburu and Gushikami districts, contaminating the nearby Kokuba River. The chemicals had been provided to local companies by the U.S. military. Children attending schools in the area said they suffered from abdominal pains and nausea. The water supply to 30,000 people and 4 villages in the southern district was stopped.
When Ryukyu government officials attempt to incinerate the chemicals, representatives of the U.S. military jumped in and stopped them. When we asked why, they said that burning the chemical could generate the world's most dangerous poison.
Officers of the U.S. military said that pentachlorophenol could create an extremely deadly toxin if incinerated. Yoshida suspected that this chemical was one of the defoliants used in Vietnam. Former Naha City Council member Chosuke Oshiro recalls what happened in 1975.
It was reported that there were huge amounts of herbicides that the U.S. military had brought back from Vietnam and stored on the shore around Camp Kinzer. A storm swept in and rolled the boxes upside down. It rained heavily for 2 or 3 days. The boxes were torn up and chemicals flowed into the sea.
When Oshiro and others rushed to the base, they found a large number of cardboard boxes. Liquid had leaked into the sea and many dead fish were found floating. The U.S. military claimed that the boxes contained the least toxic pesticides, but Oshiro doubts their explanation.
Although you can call it a type of pesticide or herbicide and use it for those purposes, it could become a defoliant when blended with other chemicals. I suspect that there were military herbicides in Okinawa.
One photograph has attracted particular attention as it seems to confirm the presence of Agent Orange in Okinawa. A service member who was working at Camp Schwab happened to take this photograph in 1970. He sent it to Mitchell. The veteran said that the barrel with the orange stripe behind him contained Agent Orange. Mitchell visited Camp Schwab to verify the location in the picture with photojournalist Goro Nakamura. Nakamura has been researching the issue of Agent Orange in Vietnam.
So it must be. This is the fence behind us, and then these rocks are here. So 40 years ago, he must have been standing right on that beach when this picture was taken. And just by chance, this barrel of Agent Orange was in the background of this shot.
Reports about Agent Orange in Okinawa have raised concerns among residents of Henoko, the area where Camp Schwab is located.
I once tried to eat fish clams that had been collected near or found under the base, but after cooking them, there was something like really black oil.
In the 1970s, I entered the sea in front of Camp Schwab and walked towards Henoko. I saw that the rocks and sand had been completely bleached white.
I'm worried about how we can take care of the safety for the children who will be born in the future. I think all the Okinawan people have to think about the issue of Agent Orange.
Camp Schwab is one of the main Marine Corps bases in Okinawa, and American troops still routinely conduct training today. A veteran stationed at the base during the early 1970s has an interesting account of drums containing Agent Orange.
I'll show you something.
Ron Fraser saw hundreds of the barrels on the base.
There was a habu on this side and a habu on this side where the barrels were, about 120 feet or something like that away from us. And we always wondered what the heck were those 55-gallon barrels with the orange ring around them.
The barrel with the orange ring matches the one in the photograph. Former journalist Kuniyoshi thought it was strange that the weeds along the perimeter fences of Camp Schwab were completely eradicated. He asked Japanese base workers about it. Kuniyoshi said he had never imagined Agent Orange was used for that purpose.
1965年からシュワブなんかも空っぽなんです。 Camp Schwab had been empty after 1965 when all the American soldiers went to Vietnam. Even though nobody was there, the weeds around the base were cleanly mowed. You could see onto the base around the perimeter fence, and people on the base could see outside. When I asked the groundskeepers, they answered that they sprayed them regularly.
It is thought there was another important reason for the U.S. military to store Agent Orange on Camp Schwab. In the nearby northern training area, the U.S. military had established a counter-guerrilla warfare school in 1961 to train military personnel for battle at dummy Vietnamese villages. It has been reported that the military brought Agent Orange there for training purposes. In fact, the U.S. government provided compensation to one of its service members who transported Agent Orange to the training area and sprayed it. The U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs made the following decision in 1998.
Credible evidence sustains a reasonable probability that the veteran was exposed to dioxins while serving in Okinawa. The veteran's recent prostate cancer must be reasonably attributed to his in-service dioxin exposure.
Here on Camp Schwab, they said that there were hundreds of barrels of Agent Orange. Because it's so near the northern training area, that it seems that they transported it from Schwab up into the northern jungles to clear the roads and to clear the mock Vietnamese villages that they made during the Vietnam War.
Meanwhile, one town in Okinawa has been rocked by fears that Agent Orange is still buried beneath its land. In Chatan, the Okinawa prefectural government has been redeveloping land returned to civilian usage by the U.S. military. One American veteran has claimed that he offloaded large amounts of Agent Orange from a ship stranded on a reef near Naha in the 1960s. The barrels were buried on what used to be Camp Hamby. Since then, the land has been given back to the prefecture. Mitchell was able to meet the veteran during his trip to the United States.
And what did you see happen at Hamby Herd?
I seen them dig holes and bury them, a lot of them. Connexes, they'd hold the connexes up. They had an RT crane, and you could put a clamp in this way, a clamp on this way, and pick the connex up and shake it, and they'd come right out.
Mitchell started to piece the story together after also obtaining information about the stranded ship from the veteran who worked at Naha Military Port.
Coral reef out there, just outside of the Naha port. LST-600, they got stuck during typhoon.
Were any of the barrels damaged?
Yes, real bad. Where they'd shifted around, they were bent. Holes in them. Some of them were completely empty.
In 2002, 187 barrels were dug up in Chatan on land returned by the American military. The prefectural government conducted an investigation of the land and water. It announced there was no damage to the environment. But the incident exposed the difficulties of dealing with land contaminated by American military installations. Article 4 of the Japan-US Status of Forces Agreement clearly states the military's position.
The United States is not obliged, when it returns facilities and areas to Japan, to the condition in which they became available to the United States Armed Forces.
In fact, the American government has no responsibility for restoring land, even if the US military contaminated it. Therefore, the Japanese government takes responsibility in such cases. However, there is another problem. Regarding the 2002 incident in Chatan, the US military insisted the barrels did not belong to them. So the Japanese government initially postponed making a decision on how to proceed. Therefore, the Chatan municipal government itself had to cover the cost of collecting the barrels. Later, it was found out that the barrels actually had belonged to the US military. The Japanese government paid the cost of the collection to the municipal government. They called it a consolatory payment.
The town put up about 20 million yen. We wanted to recoup our money as soon as possible, but we were told that the situation would get complicated and our repayment delayed if we claimed the money as compensation. So we tried to get the money back under any name the Japanese government called it. We accept it as a so-called solation.
The Japanese government stated that they couldn't find and they cannot find any documents confirming the transportation of Agent Orange in Okinawa.
The Japanese government itself has never specifically launched an investigation into the case.
The Japanese government says the U.S. Department of Defense announced there were no records of transporting Agent Orange into Okinawa. Even though the government says it will launch an investigation, it hasn't done so yet. We would like to ease the public's concerns over the situation by contacting the former members of the U.S. military who claim Agent Orange was present on Okinawa.
According to the veterans, there are 15 U.S. military installations where Agent Orange was stored or sprayed in Okinawa. Mitchell claims that these are just a small fraction of the much larger picture. There are at least 132 Americans who claim they are suffering from health problems due to exposure to Agent Orange while serving on Okinawa.
There are 15 bases where these chemicals were stored, or they were sprayed, or they were transported, or even they were buried. So it's not only on Schwab. It's 15 bases from the northern Yambaru, from the northern training area in the north, going down through Kadena, through Futenma, down to Naha Port in the south.
The veterans' testimonies show that Okinawa was used for hosting storage facilities for Agent Orange. And this deadly poison was dispersed in the vicinity of the island's communities on a daily basis.
It's on contract, or were they Okinawan police? I don't know. See, we always called them Okinawan.
Humans were not the only victims of Agent Orange. Many dogs were brought to the battlefields during the Vietnam War. At Okinawa's Yomitan Dog School, military dogs and soldiers who worked with canine units were trained. Don Schneider, who was a veterinarian, says habu snakes used to live in the grass and bite the dogs. So the U.S. military sprayed Agent Orange to kill the grass and keep away the snakes.
But also
at the same time, Schneider saw Agent Orange sprayed from the jeeps in the northern training area where the dogs were brought for the drills.
John was born in
Yeah, but come see.
There was a blood disease that broke out amongst dogs coming back from Vietnam and from dogs on Okinawa. And the common denominator was, of course, that these dogs in Okinawa and in Vietnam were exposed to Agent Orange. The dogs would bleed from the nose, mouth, around their ears, every orifice imaginable. They'd become emaciated, they would lose a lot of weight, they would lose fur, they just looked in horrible condition.
This is artwork by Schneider, which shows the scenery of Okinawa. Schneider came to love Okinawa and had close relationships with local people. He felt disconsolate about the fact that Okinawa had become involved in the ugly war in Vietnam.
It was a horrible thing to see, and you know, Okinawa being used. It was difficult for us, for instance, to experience getting to know the kids who were assigned as dog handlers going over to Vietnam, and then the dog coming back 60 days later. You know, the kid died. Not a pleasant thing. But to get back, yes, Okinawa was a center and was essential to the American war effort. And I've always felt that Okinawans, the people, were badly used. You know, and they didn't deserve it. You know, they were a beautiful people.
At the end of his journey, Mitchell wanted to meet someone who could confirm the damages caused by Agent Orange in Okinawa.
Mr. Carlson.
Welcome, John. How are you?
Really, really nice to meet you, mate.
Yes, sir.
Really. Thank you so much for inviting us.
Yes, sir.
I really appreciate it. Thank you. You've got a beautiful house here.
Well, thank you. It's really a modest one.
Is your health okay?
Yeah, I'm doing pretty good.
Please just tell us.
The U.S. government has admitted that Larry Carlson was harmed by Agent Orange in Okinawa. It has been compensating him since 2010. In the document that Carlson submitted to the U.S. government, he clearly wrote the place where he was exposed to Agent Orange. Carlson got drenched with Agent Orange while he was transporting it from Naha Military Port to Kadena Air Base or Marine Corps installations.
I saw one note on one time when a guy read the x-ray.
Some of the drums coming off the ship were half full because they had leaked, and we would touch the drums because we had climbed up to unhook the chains. And when we unhooked the chains, we exposed ourselves to the pure dioxin.
Carlson suffers from a number of serious illnesses, including Parkinson's disease and lung cancer. So far, three people, including Carlson, have received compensation relating to Agent Orange in Okinawa. Carlson has testified that health damages were caused by Agent Orange used specifically in Okinawa. However, the U.S. government suddenly announced that they would terminate Carlson's compensation payments this May. Carlson thinks he knows the reason why.
They don't want to compensate anybody for Okinawa because of the potential. It's like an iceberg. You don't know. You see the tip of the iceberg. We don't know how much is under the water. So that kind of leaves with a question mark of how much would it cost to compensate everybody.
Before Before Okinawa's reversion to Japanese sovereignty, the U.S. military moved its stockpiles of toxic gases and chemical weapons from Okinawa to Johnson Island in 1971. Some veterans assert that those shipments included Agent Orange. On May 15, 1972, Okinawa returned to Japanese sovereignty. Okinawa has recently marked the 40th anniversary of his return to Japan, but the U.S. military bases still remain in Okinawa. Okinawan people are in the dark about what kinds of weapons the U.S. military uses here and how they are stored on the bases. Agent Orange was used in Vietnam and its frontline wartime base, Okinawa. However, there has never been any investigation into how Okinawan people's health may have been damaged by Agent Orange.
So for me, this is just a start. I've been inspired by talking to these veterans, by visiting in their homes, by meeting their friends and meeting their family, and it's given me a lot of confidence to keep pursuing this with everything that I have in my power. At some time, the American government will admit to this horrible poison having been used on Okinawa during this period.
Now, we know it's there. Tell the government, or the VA or whoever, say, okay, you prove that it was not there. I want you to prove that it was not there.
I'm going to assume that there is still some pollution. So I think that perhaps what Okinawa should look for is prior to these bases being given back, to see what's being done and to ask what's being done.
The issue of Agent Orange in Okinawa is a striking symbol of the ties that bind Okinawa to war. The story of Agent Orange shows that not only were Okinawan people exposed to its dangers without their knowledge during the Vietnam War, but they might be further exposed to other environmental and human dangers in the future.